Hello, welcome to the project deployment tutorial for EcoStruxure Energy Hub. In this second chapter, Deployment of Energy Hub, we will see how to deploy an energy hub system from site to organization level. In this topic, third-party device integration in Energy Hub using Panel Server, we will learn how to integrate third-party, non-Schneider electric, electricity, water or gas meters in EcoStruxure Energy Hub using custom models for EcoStruxure Panel Server. Panel Server does not provide native support for certain Schneider and other third-party Modbus devices. It may appear as unknown or may not even be visible on the web page. So, for integrating these devices to Energy Hub, a custom model needs to be created for Panel Server. The custom model is a configuration file that maps device measurements, allowing the Panel Server to communicate with third-party devices. To create and export custom models for Panel Server, EcoStruxure Power Commission web tool is used. Before getting started, please be ready with the Modbus register list of the respective third-party device. In the device register list, please make sure the required business quantities required for Energy Hub are available to show proper data in the screens and dashboards as per the subscription. For detailed list of business quantities and the corresponding measurements, please go to the user community and refer this post. Please download the attached document with appendices to refer later. A business quantity is a group of measurements that have similar functionality. When a business quantity is selected in Energy Hub, it will try to show you the most relevant measurement you have available for that device. As per the product type, for each business quantity, you need to have at least one measurement in the business quantity group mapped in the Panel Server model for it to show in Energy Hub. If multiple measurements for a device are imported, then the business quantity will return the measurement higher in priority. Let's start by logging in to EcoStruxure Power Commission web portal. If you are already logged in to Energy Hub or user community, you will be automatically logged in if you access the portal from the specific browser. Else need to register. Please provide your credentials. Make sure to set your new password as per the mentioned password policy. Next, fill the required details. Click Register. You will reach the home screen of EcoStruxure Power Commission web portal. To demonstrate, we're utilizing the Schneider PM1225H meter for custom model creation. Since this device isn't natively supported in Panel Server, the procedure remains consistent with any third-party Modbus meter. Click Create Model. Enter product name of the device which you are going to create the custom model. The portal will indicate whether anyone has already created a custom model for this device. If the custom model is already available with the required measurements, then it is recommended to use that model. If you need to modify, go to Duplicate or create a new version of the model. Do the required changes and export. If there is no existing model available, click Could not find any matching model. Here, we have two options to create the mode. If you have already created a custom model in COMEX, then you can import it here to create the model for Panel Server. Else we need to it manually by starting to fill these details. Fill the product name, model name, and brand. Please make sure you don't keep the product brand as default Schneider Electric. Mention the product range. While providing the product family, please make sure it matches with an Energy Hub concept type. Like for a Modbus power metering device, power meter will be the concept type. Commercial reference to be left blank. For water or gas meters, IO device will be the concept type and the same to be filled for product family. For product range, standard underscore pulse to be given and in place of commercial reference, generic underscore pulse underscore input to be mentioned. In both cases, for customized for applications, select EcoStruxure Energy Hub from drop-down. If at product level byte swapping is enabled, then select the same, else keep default, no swap. provide description if needed. Click Create. We can add the measurements one by one or import as bulk using the template. Let's do it one by one. Click Add New. From the Modbus register list of the device and the Appendix C, in the downloaded document, select the business quantity, measurement name, and the respective PDM short name. Update the respective short name against each measurement in the register list to refer later. First measurement is active energy delivered. Select the short name, which we had taken from Appendix C. Provide this short name in the field. Accordingly, the measurement name will be automatically populated. Provide the data type as encoding. Other few fields are automatically populated. Register start address will be one less than the register number. Here in the portal, the unit corresponding to this measurement is WH, but in the device Modbus table, it is kilowatt hour. So, provide the scale factor as 1000. Click Create Another and click Add. Please make sure the PDM tag has appeared in the added measurement. Repeat the steps for the next measurement, active power total. For the measurements like current, if the unit is same in device Modbus list and portal, then the scale factor will be 1. Repeat the steps for all the required measurements. Click Next. Event screen is for creating custom events for each parameter. This feature is not currently supported in Energy Hub, so we can leave this for now. Alternatively, we can create software alarms for few parameters in Energy Hub as per the subscription activated. Click Next. To generate the Modbus frames, you can auto-generate or create custom frames if any specific changes needed. Let's click Auto-Generate Frames. Click Finish. Now your custom model is ready. Go to Export Models. My Models. Click on the model you just created and click Add to Export. Click Export Selection. Save to your computer. Now let's import this model to Panel Server. Please make sure the third-party Modbus device is properly wired and connected to Panel Server. Go to Panel Server webpage. Modbus Devices. Custom Models. Click Import. Select the already exported model from EcoStruxure Power Commission web portal. It will show up with the version. Now let's add the third-party device and assign this custom model. Provide the Modbus slave ID of the device. From the drop-down menu, select the custom model. Click Add. The device is added to Panel Server. Provide the respective contextualization data. Go to Monitoring and Control and select the device to check the parameters. All the parameters are coming correctly. If the Panel Server is already connected to Energy Hub, go to Data Publication and republish the topology. If the Panel Server is not yet connected to cloud and not claimed in Energy Hub, please follow the steps in the videos, Panel Server Configuration for Energy Hub, and Energy Hub Basic Setup. Make sure you are logged in to Energy Hub and have completed the basic settings, with advanced or plus advanced subscription activated for your organization. Go to your organization in Energy Hub. Add the Panel Server to the site if it is not already done. Go to Investigate. Go to Energy View and click the third-party device. Check the updated data. Go to Asset View and check the parameters. If you want to add any parameters or do any modifications in the custom model, go to EcoStruxure Power Commission web portal and click on the model. Let's add one parameter here. Click Add New. Provide the details and click Add. Now click Publish New Version. Click Publish. New version of the model is ready. Click Export now to download the model. Now go to Panel Server webpage. Click Modbus Devices, Custom Models. Click Import and select the downloaded new version of the model. It will show that the new version is added. Now click Update Model to enable the new version to the associated devices. Go to the third-party device to check the new version is updated with the newly added parameter. Go to Data Publication and Publish Topology. Go to Energy Hub and check the respective device to see the new parameter addition. Now you can assign this device to the respective location in your energy hierarchy. Please watch the video on energy hierarchy and settings for more details. Congratulations! You have successfully integrated a third-party device to Energy Hub. Thanks for watching this video. Please watch the next videos in the project deployment series to easily deploy your EcoStruxure Energy Hub system.